the episode, and you make me make a decision, and you have me make a decision. You know what? Okay, I'm going to save and then make my choice. There we go. We're going to take the book. I stare at the book as it moves up and down with Rin's chest. Memorize. I mean, it could be the outstanding placement, but I really can't take my eyes off it. The book has a very plain, round binding. This time it's whole on cover. And that's the most unusual thing about it. From what I can tell, anyway, does it really contain some sinister power and stuff? What are you hiding? It's not even about the book itself. Now that I think of it, Rin was acting strange. I asked her about the fine. I'm not allowed to give secrets at something in the house I live in. I mean, I should probably just go for it. What if there's something I want to be aware of? I slowly put the book out of Prince's relaxed finger and froze for a moment. Prince still peacefully asleep. And I got an achievement! Curiosity killed the cat. No, come on! I breathe out of sleep, breathe out softly, and start examining my couch. And you give me even more! Choices. I'm gonna do another save. Yeah. Well, where else to start? But the beginning. This is my name. My name is Yoshinori Jiro, and I intend to dedicate my life to exposing a great lie. The lie that has put our allies to fight and strengthened the foes of every living thing bound to this land. A lie the Fukuyama clan, blinded by greed, has been repelled and repeated for generations. Fukuyama? No wonder Rin didn't want to let me run. Mumbles something in her sleep and starts moving. I froze in panic. But my relief, Rin simply turns over. That's it for me. I don't feel like taking any more chances. Ah. But the strange book didn't. I put the strange book down by the couch and hurry to get out of the room quickly. What if this thing is actually cursed? I really don't want to explain myself to Rin in case something happens. After all the messing around with the old furniture, I absolutely have faith before going to bed. I rummage through the closet for suitable towels. But I can't get the strange book out of my head. Or should I say the diary? Fukuyama blinded by greed. Rin seems to be blinded by anything but greed. What? Thank you. your story is maybe it's the mother of the diary who is trying to slam the young ship. Then I think it is all that. There's something in the mirror. It scares me half to death.
It's it.
It makes me it takes me a minute to realize that it's just a piece of paper with strange symbols on it. Damn it, Rin! I got here too! Okay, if that's what it takes, let it be. I mean, at least now I have a high occult security bathroom. Yeah. Ah, here too? There's another piece of scribbled paper glued to one of the tubes. It looks like a daring strawberries scented bath for me. Home to me. Well, Rin must have turned it somehow, or a doorway to the demon world. Okay, I've heard a couple of creepy stories on how mirrors can pose a danger. But my favorite bath home, just why? it's magic guy girls. I'm a little hesitant, but Rin probably knows best. I'll take a different tube. Am I gonna be safe? I'm gonna take this if I am safe! It feels so good. As soon as the foamy water touches my skin, all the worries of the day was set. Oh, wow. I filled the tub with hot water and climbed a pile of scented foam. The water makes my body warm, nice and light, and my big muscles finally relax. The air feels thick and viscous because of the steam. Room gradually filled with smooth herb fragrance. I carefully rest my head on the tub. I better not fall asleep right here. My eyelids are growing heavy. I give in a moment of weakness and begin to develop with my pleasure. Through my body. For a while, I just listened to the kind of bubble and a foam crack. It goes in empty in my head while it begins to fill. Kitsune. Who would have thought they existed? I open my eyes and stare at the white ceiling. If only I had known, I would have never. Oh, what's that? Turns out the ceiling is not entirely white. There's something on it, rather. Another stain? Maybe the roof is leaking? Never mind. I'll clean it up tomorrow. Oh, well. This house never ends. The light flickers. Great. Now it's the... Suddenly I feel movement. A straight chair clogged in the back seat, side down, as if something heavy were hanging from it. Another one slid down my shoulder, crawling to my collarbone. I realized that it's not my hair. And it reaches my throat. I grab it with all my strength, and try pulling it away, but it doesn't work. The strands is tight, slimy. My fingernails are tangled, but it works. Naturally, my hair. And help me! My arms and legs have been twisted and pulled in directions. On ceiling, stretches, staring into the classroom. Ceiling swell, bulges, and finally bursts. An abnormal whirl is gapping above. My leg hangs off. Leg goes to the power. No! Break it! Until the pearl soap from foam is colored red pink. Oh, under flight. It's the last choice, of course! My back. My sight goes dim. I didn't have the strength to fight. I'm coming! Be gone! She just pulls out a cross and a Bible. Patches of color float before my eyes. Simmer. So familiar. It's red. Red? Not red! But instead of face, I see a terrible creature, like a cracked old moon. She is slowly leaning over. Oh, I'm trying to pull myself away with the last of my strength. My head bumps into something. I grab it and throw it up above. It seizes. Yeah! It's okay. I'm here, June. I open my eyes. Quack, that was close. 10 out of 10, I was not expecting another freaking achievement. It is beside me. It's perfectly normal. We're sitting in the bathroom floor. That weird fragrance. I have water steaming off me, flooding the floor. I have to wipe it. Okay. At least they're nice enough to give us a fucking towel. Thank you. I have even less editing to do. That's actually great. Thank you. I'm actually happy. I don't want to do editing. And I know that if I don't edit it, YouTube would be very, very mad. Ren covers me with a large towel, blunt in the water, and suddenly pulls me close to her chest. What? Don't worry about it. Ren? Let's get out of here. Can you walk? I think so. There's a little piece of something crunched underfoot. Assaults? There's an empty plastic jar by the door, and Ren kicks it out of the way. We sit down on the couch. I'm starting to shake. Ren wraps something around me, squeezes my hand. You're really cold. I'll make you some tea. Okay? I nod. Ren glances back at me a few times, but eventually leaves the kitchen. I feel like a long time has passed. Ren doesn't come back. I look around this room. Things in their places. Everything seems somehow unfamiliar. We will figure it out next episode! So, I hope you guys have a great day too. Like question. What developers are planning to do? So, I'll see you guys next time.